Well, we've been talking a lot this week about New Year's resolutions. Here's what we know about them. First off, half of you make them. After a week, 25% of you have already failed. Half of you have given up after 6 months. After a year, most have failed. So, if this is indeed your year to keep your goals, teen expert Dr. Russell Hyken is here with how you can truly stick to them. Good morning to you.
Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely. So, what do we need to do to ensure success this year?
Well, the first thing is everybody can actually set goals. So when you look at those statistics, the problem there is that people aren't setting goals properly. So probably the first and most important thing is be really specific.
Okay.
You know, goals that are too vague are hard to reach. You know, so when your teenager says to you, listen, Mom, this is the semester I am going to make A's. Well, if they've never made A's, it's probably not going to happen. Rather, what they should do is look at a subject area or two where they would really benefit from improving and really focus on those while maintaining their other grades.
So be very specific when you're setting your goals.
Yes.
Okay. Make your goals personal.
Right. And that's really important, too, because you know what? If you do your goals out of obligation, if I make a goal to please my wife or my kids make a goal to please their girlfriends, boyfriends, parents, whatever, you're just setting yourself up for not only failure, but also you might let down that person that you're doing the goal for. So if you want to do something, if you want to recycle and make the world more green, make sure you're doing it because you want to, not because somebody else thinks that you should.
Don't make a goal to kind of change someone else.
Right, right.
Okay.
Because it's just hard to follow through. It's just the motivation isn't there.
Okay, third is share your goals.
Yeah, and that's a really, really important one. Write it down. Put it on the refrigerator. Tell a couple of friends. What you're trying to do is build a support network, but also kind of get some internal motivation to make that goal actually happen. So you know what? If you can actually find like-minded people that share the same goal, then do that. If you want to improve fitness, join a running club. Improve study habits, join an after-work homework club, after-school homework club.
All right. The fourth is give it time.
Yeah, the brain takes some time to adapt to a new behavior, anywhere from a few weeks to a few months. So it's really important to keep that aspect in mind as you go forward. And as you set those goals, there are bound to be setbacks. And don't let those setbacks get you down. They're temporary. And if you can get right back at it, then the brain isn't going to lose focus on that goal.
Yeah, we're talking just because, you know, you may have failed one day. Don't think you have to wait till next year to have that goal again. Get right back on it.
You know, if your goal is to lose weight and you ate too much one day or you had a bad lunch, you know what? That next meal, get right back into it and start over. And don't beat yourself up over it. Keep moving forward.
All right. And finally, and I really like this one, goals are different than dreams.
Yeah, I like dreams. Yeah. Dream big. You know, last night, many of us thought about winning the lottery, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
You know, and I encourage people to do that. That's fun. But goals are different. Goals, I like to use the acronym SMART. They should be specific, measurable, attainable, tangible, and realistic. So if you kind of keep all these tips in mind, you plan for SMART goals, then you have your best chance at ensuring success.
I like all these. Dr. Russell Hyken, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Great
we appreciate it. For more information about Dr. Hyken, go to stlmoms.com. Look under our STL Moms expert section. John and Randy?
Good stuff to remember. Thank you.
Yeah.